Hello everyone, welcome back to another lecture of Chemical Process Design and Simulations, course code CHE446. So as we know, there are four CLOs of this course. Number one is related to the fundamentals, number two is related to simulation, number three is related to the analysis, and number four is related to the design. So our this activity is linked with CLO number one and partially with CLO number four. We will use the problem table approach. Basically, we will use these two methods to find the utilities requirement for us heat exchange system and the pinch temperatures, and then we will move forward to the much complex system based on the concepts from this exercise. Now the problem table approach comparatively easier than the graphical method, or you may disagree with it, that we will be using the shifted temperature intervals from the stream supply, and for the hot stream we will subtract delta T min over 2 from the values, and for cold stream we will add delta T min over 2 from these values. And in each shifted temperature interval we will calculate a simple energy balance. And how we can calculate it? Delta H I is equal to cold stream Cp of C minus hot stream Cp of H multiplied by delta T I. That Cp of cold stream, in our case, it is currently 1, and Cp of H, which is 1.8. So 1 minus 1.8 multiplied by temperature interval. But obviously you might be confusing, so we will now shift to the problem table approach. But one thing for sure, if the cold stream dominates the hot stream, means if Cp of C, this answer is in positive, means Cp of C is higher than Cp of H, then the interval has net deficit. It means we need to supply heat, and delta H is positive. If hot stream dominate cold stream, the interval has a net surplus of heat and delta H is negative. Obviously, if Cp of H is higher than Cp of C, then the whole answer will be negative, and it means we have high, or it means we have surplus energy available and we can provide it and exchange it. And if Cp of C is higher than Cp of H, then obviously delta H will be positive. Mathematical calculations. So this is the same initial temperature, 20 degree centigrade, 200 degree centigrade, 150 degree centigrade for hot and 50 outlet, and 180 kilowatt heat load for cold stream, 180 kilowatt heat load for hot stream. Cp value is given 1 and 1.8. Now hot stream interval is calculated by this is actual temperature minus delta T minimum over 2. Means if your delta T minimum is 20 degree centigrade, then 20 over 2, 10. So if I take you to here, 150 degree centigrade is your actual temperature. We are taking delta T minimum as 20 degree centigrade. So 20 over 2 means 10. 150 minus 10 will be 140. Similarly, 50 minus 10 will be 40. And you have to do opposite for cold stream, that you have to add it. So 20 plus 10, 30. 200 plus 10, 210. So this is the first table. Now we can see we have now four temperature values. 210. We have to look shifted temperature value over here, not these values. We have to use these values: 210, 140, 40, and 30. From 30 to 210, we have cold stream. From 140 to 40, we have hot stream in shifted temperature approach. So first we will plot the intervals: 210, 140, 40, and 30, as we have discussed. These are the intervals. As you can see, there are three intervals: 210 to 140, 140 to 40, and 40 to 30 degree centigrade. And you can see this is the first stream, which is the cold stream, which is labeled as blue, 30 degree centigrade to 210 degree centigrade. And this is the second stream, which is going from 140 degree centigrade to 40 degree centigrade. This is very, very simple, but now the bigger part will come. I have divided this activity into smaller parts so that you can understand the problem table approach, because this is our first task. Now, this T star temperature interval 210, 140, 40, 30. This is the same interval. Again, number one stream, its Cp value is 1. And this is the hot stream, its Cp value is minus 1.8. Obviously, I have placed minus because in the formula it was Cp of C minus Cp of H. So it will be easier for you to subtract it. And now delta T interval. As you can see, the temperature difference is 70 degree centigrade over here. So it is plus 70. The temperature interval over here is 140 minus 40, 100 degree centigrade. And here 40 minus 30, so it is plus 10. Your next task, after doing, because this we have already done in our previous slide, but when you will be solving exercise at after getting some experience, then you can start directly over here as well. Then you have to calculate the Cp of C minus Cp of H, because you know that for the calculation of delta H, these two parameters are required. Cp of C minus Cp of H multiplied by delta T interval. So as you can see that in this first interval, there is only one stream, that is stream number 1. So there is no Cp of H. So what it will be? Cp of C minus Cp. This summation means when you have more than one stream. But in this case, there is no summation rule. So as you can see, this one means it will be plus 1 over here. In the second region where there is a delta T of 100 degree centigrade, both these streams are involving. So that will be Cp of H minus Cp of C. So that will be minus 0.8. Don't confuse with this minus. Don't take it as 1 minus minus 1.8. So minus minus will be plus. Don't take it like this. You can even don't consider this minus, and you can take it directly as 1 minus 1.8. But this minus 1.8 is just for the sake of easiness. Ki aap logon ki aasani ke liye kiya gaya ki maine yahan directly minus 1.8 likh diya hai. Aur iska matlab ye matlab nahi hai ki aap isko minus minus ko plus kar do. Then again in the third region, there is only one stream, that is a cold stream whose Cp is 1. Now what you need to do, you need to multiply these two to get the value of delta H interval. So that will be plus 70, that will be minus 80, and that will be plus 10. And I had told you that if the value of delta H is positive, then it means it is surplus or deficit. Obviously it is deficit. And once it is negative, it is surplus and plus deficit. So this is the first major part of our problem table approach. In the second case, we will again draw this temperature interval, as you can see, and hot utility is required above this point. Obviously, you will be knowing that to take it from 140 to 210 degree centigrade, you require hot utility. So hot utility will always be at top, as we have seen in the graphical method as well. So you can go back and check that in graphical method, the hot utility is on the higher side, because you need it for the cold stream, and the cold utility is at the lower side. And you can see this delta H is plus 70. Then in this interval, it is minus 80. And this in this interval, it is plus 10. So I'm hopeful that you know that from where these values came. These values came from the previous slide. As you can see in this interval, it is plus 70. In this, it is minus 80. And in this, it is plus 10. So that is what I have plotted over here in the diagram, that here it is hot utility. In this interval, delta H is 70, minus 80, and plus 10. Then was our first task now here, because these are all mandatory tasks, is to take point as 0, plus 0. And then what we need to do, this parameter, this which is plus 0, minus this one, this delta H. So that is minus 70 kilowatt. Remember one thing, that once after doing this task, which we have done in the previous slide, we need to come to this kilowatt first, or heat load, and we need to firstly specify the upper value as 0. Then we need to simply subtract this, like 0 minus 70 is minus 70. Then minus 70 minus 80. So minus 70 minus this. Now it has already negative sign with it. So minus minus plus. So minus 70 minus minus plus 80. So minus 70 plus 80 will be plus 10. And then plus 10 minus 10 will be 0. So that's a basic mathematical calculations. And I am hopeful that you are obviously that these calculations are clear to you in this exercise. Now again, you need to draw the same column over here. Again, the same lines, hot utility here, cold utility here. And now at which point you are getting the minus value? Obviously, you are getting the minus value at 140 degree centigrade. Remember this point only. We will come back at it a bit later. And the lowest value among these is minus 70. So what we need to do, first we need to take it as at here, like the same, and then kilowatt. Now what we need to do, we need to take this value here, like instead of plus 0, the lowest value among all these, that it is 0, minus 70, plus 10, plus 0. So the lowest value is minus 70 over here. So what we need to do, we need to take this 70 over here. Now we need to just simply subtract it. 70 minus 70, 0. Then 0 minus minus, so it will be plus 80. And then 80 minus 10, it will be 70. So as you can see, this plus 70 corresponds to the heating utility, and this plus 70 corresponds to the cooling utility. And if you remember that in graphical method, for a delta T minimum of 20 degrees centigrade, we have calculated the exactly same values of 70 kilowatt for heating utility and 70 kilowatt for cooling utility. Now, a question might be raising in your mind that why we have drawn the two loops. This is the infeasible cascade because there is a one value that is negative. For a feasible cascade, all the values should be positive, which is in this case. The first cascade is usually the infeasible cascade, while the second cascade is always the feasible one. And remember one thing, for its feasibility, all the values should be positive. If there is a single negative value, even if there are 100 values and one of them is negative, then it will be a infeasible cascade. So you can see that by using graphical method or by using problem table approach, the hot utility and cold utility requirements are same. Now, what is your pinch temperature? Pinch point, that is the point at which you are getting this zero value. So this corresponds to this 140 degree centigrade. But now you need to return the values because 140 is not your actual value. It is a shifted value. So what you need to do, you need to go back. The pinch temperature is 140 degree centigrade. The hot pinch temperature, how you can calculate? Now you have to do the reverse calculation. Earlier you subtracted from the hot side and added in the cold side. Now you have to do the opposite. That the pinch temperature is 140 degree centigrade. Pinch temperature plus delta T minimum over 2, which is 10. So 140 plus 10 is 150 degree centigrade, and cold pinch temperature is 140 minus 10 degree centigrade, which is 130 degree centigrade. And hot utility requirement is 70 kilowatt. Cold utility requirement is 70 kilowatt. If I take you to the graphical method, which is at 20 degree centigrade, then you can see the hot pinch temperature is 150 degree centigrade corresponds to this point, and the cold pinch temperature is 130 degree centigrade corresponds to this point. This region, the region is 70 kilowatt, and in this region, the requirement of utility is 70 kilowatt. So as you can see, the values coming in both graphical method and in problem table approach are same. And even you can do back calculations to find the same pinch temperature. How? That it's 130 degree centigrade. So 130 plus 10, 140 degree centigrade pinch temperature. 150 minus 10, 140 degree centigrade as pinch temperature. So the pinch temperature, the pinch points, and the utility requirements, all the values are same in both graphical and problem table approach. But both procedures are now in front of you, and it's your choice which method to be used in your future calculations. But for our course, obviously, we will be using the both methods. So now, after going through this extensive exercise, I have been assigning you this problem statement that the cold stream is at 40 degrees centigrade, 110 is the outlet temperature, with a heat load of 14 megawatts. So what will be the CP? Calculate it. I have told you its procedure, that how you calculate heat load by multiplying CP by the difference of these two. Now it's opposite of it. And then hot stream is given to you and roll numbers are assigned. The value of delta T minimum as this 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18. So you have to submit with this and that will be counting towards your attendance of this lecture. If you are unable to submit it by the deadline, then unfortunately, your attendance won't be counted. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much.